Are you one of the few barbershops that are still open right now and are just curious what other side hustles you can start to help bring in some extra cash? Or are you one of the many shops that are closed right now and you're just wondering what other ways that you can leverage your barbering experience to help bring in some extra money, especially during these uncertain times? My name is Mike Joseph, founder of Visual Media Marketing, the number one advertising agency for barbershops. In today's video, I'm going to go over 8 different side hustles that you can use to start implementing in your shops to help bring in some extra cash. But before I begin, just want to let everyone know my opinion on having a side hustle and the downsides that come with it versus the pros that come with it too. Obviously, we know what that side hustle is great. It's extra income, another stream of income to add to that, extra cash. It's perfect, right? My thing is if you're looking at different side hustles, you should be at a point where you're making the most you can at your current shop. So let's say, for example, you're a barber and you're at full capacity, you can't take on any more customers, you're fully booked. Now you're either wondering, okay, should I increase my prices or should I start looking at other revenue points to bring in extra cash? That's what, in my opinion, the perfect time to look for a side hustle. If you are on the other side of the spectrum where, you're a barber or you're a shop owner, but you're not, sometimes business is slow, depending on the season, obviously, and you just want to look for extra money, there's different strategies that you can use in your barbershop to help bring in more customers. And if that's the case, check out this video. I have a video that's titled 11 Different Marketing Strategies, Ideas, Tips for Barbershops. So definitely look at that and make sure you go through that list. Those are excellent ways to help bring in customers, especially if you have a lot of downtime. Other than that, because the thing is if you have a side hustle and you start putting more energy towards that side hustle, you tend to neglect your actual business that's already generating you money. Okay, so again, I just wanted to be very clear on that, is focus on your brand right now and building that to become a successful business or achieving your goals. And I have videos that go over goal setting and how to make X amount of money in your shop, which I'll also link here. Make sure you watch those before you start looking into any other side hustles. Another thing that I wanted to cover with you guys is in this video, the side hustles that I'm going to be sharing with you aren't the, hey, get a part-time job, hey, let's do Forex trading, or let's sell real estate. No, it's not nothing like that, because the main reason why I don't want to go over those basic or very vague side hustles is you tend to need a particular set of skills, and there's a huge learning curve that comes with it. So the side hustles that I'll be sharing in this video are ones that you can leverage with your barbering experience that's very specific to the barbering industry. That way it's not that big of a learning curve and you can start making some quick cash now rather than later. So with that being said, let's begin. So number one, being a mobile barber, right? I know it's still very new, but there's a lot of barbers out there that are doing it right now. Some of them are doing mobile barbering full time, which is great. But if you're at a shop and times are slow, or you're tired of waiting for businesses to come to you and you'd rather get up and go after it, being a mobile barber on the side is a perfect way to bring in some extra cash, perfect way to have a side hustle. Now, just to give you something that's a little bit more practical, think about who you can go to that can't really leave their homes or they can't really leave their jobs, right? So I'm thinking if I want to be a mobile barber, I'll go after nursing homes, because majority of these times these older people, they won't be able to leave their establishments. So definitely go visit them and you can start being a mobile barber at these facilities. Another great place to go to is car dealerships, because most of the times, and me, I used to work at a car dealer as a salesperson, and the issue is when you're a salesperson, you never want to leave the floor because you're always missing opportunities on when I come in ready to buy a car. So salespeople tend to stay at these dealerships from morning to sundown, right? So and they might not have the time to be able to leave their place to go get a haircut, but you can go to these dealerships, strike up some type of deal or strategic partnership where you can come in and be that mobile barber that visits them once or twice a week on your days off and cut their hair. It's a perfect side hustle for you, especially if you want to be a mobile barber or just to keep, it's not a big learning curve. And that's what most of these side hustles are, is not huge learning curves. It's another ways that you can make money using your expertise. Number two is hosting networking events. Obviously, right now, it's going to be a little bit hard, especially with COVID-19. But obviously, when things start to blow over, it's a great way to help bring in some extra cash. What I mean by hosting networking events, maybe hosting gaming tournaments or if you decide to create a partnership with another barber educator or yourself. If you are a barber educator, you can host workshops where you're going over different techniques and different ways that, you know, to show professionalism in the barber place, or you can just teach aspiring barbers how to cut hair right inside your barbershop. Actually, one of my clients out here, we did something just like that, where we had an educator come in. They paid us a percentage of the ticket sales that came in, and it was an extra $400 or $500 in a weekend. So it was definitely worth doing. It's ideal if you have the space for it in your barbershop. If you're a three chair shop, it's gonna be very hard to have something like that. It might not be as realistic. But if you do have these shops that have 8 or 9 chairs where you have the space for it, definitely do it. And number three, selling your products online. So if you're one of the many shops that has products inside your store, different gels, beard oils, pomades, if you have any of those, definitely want to create an online store where your customers can visit and make those purchases. Great way to bring in extra cash on the side and to keep revenue coming in, especially during a time like this where people can't go to your shop, or for most people, they won't be able to go into your shop. Selling clippers, another great product to have in your store, especially during a time like this where everybody is stuck at home and they're gonna have to learn how to cut their hair on their own until barbershops are allowed to reopen. If you're a shop that is currently open, definitely recommend that you sell the pomades, the gels, the beard oils, all that to help bring in some extra cash. And number four, selling online merchandise. Great way to make some extra cash. And I'm not just talking about selling products. That was number three. Selling merchandise, I'm talking about t-shirts with your logo on it, hats, hoodies. This is a great way to help increase your brand awareness as well as make some extra cash on the side. If you don't know where to begin when it comes to selling online merch, you can use sites like teespring.com, which will allow you to create the shirt, right? You'll send them a logo. You can place it on their site. You can place the logo onto whatever shirt, hoodie, hat, whatever you're making, and they will ship it for you. So this way you don't have to deal with the logistics of warehousing everything, knowing everyone's shipping address, you know, all that, like any return, they'll handle all that for you. This way you're not gonna have to have a trunk full of your t-shirts and hoodies, or have to sell them outside the shop where it's taking up space inside your shop. You don't have to do that. Use sites like teespring.com. There's a few others too. Great way to help get the brand out there. Number five, selling promo. Now you can do this on Instagram or having a blog site or any other social media really, but let's just focus for this example on Instagram. Let's say you create an Instagram page sharing viral content around the barbering industry. So what you're doing is you're reposting pictures that you're finding on the Explorer page under best haircuts and things like that. So you're taking this content, you're continuing to post it, and you're growing your Instagram page. Let's say it grows to 1,000, 5,000, 10K or whatever. The thing is you're creating an audience of people that other people are going to want to advertise against. So let's say you have this Instagram page. Let's just say it's called Best Barbers, and you've gotten it up to like 4,000 followers. Let's just be realistic. You guys have 4,000 followers. And now what's going to happen is you're going to have other people reach out to you for promo. So advertising companies might reach out to you and say, hey, I want to pay you $50 for a post, $100 for a post, whatever it is. You really get to determine that price. So you're going to get advertisers reaching out to you, maybe other influencers looking to grow their followers so they can have people of your audience following them. Or you might get people like let's say Walls Pro or Andy's Clippers, right? People who want to tap into your audience so they can further grow their brand or sell their product. So that's a great way to help grow, have a side hustle around your industry, right? You're still being a part of it, and it's a great tool to actually just research and seeing what the best haircuts are. But again, you're creating an audience of people in which you can sell to or sell advertising space to. People pay anywhere from 25, 50, 100, or even more just for an Instagram post. So there's no reason why you can't be the influencer on the other side selling promo for your shop. And number six, selling real estate. Now, I know what you might be thinking. You said that you weren't going to talk about flipping houses or buying houses or anything. I'm not talking about that. I'm not talking about properties. I'm talking about real estate inside your barbershop. What I mean by this is the real estate in front of your clients, right? I've been to enough barbershops to know that this is a common trait in most shops. And it's crazy to me that a lot of them are doing this for free. So, for example, a client will come to your shop, they'll sit in your chair, you turn them around, and you start cutting, and the mirror is facing them. On that mirror, there happens to be a bunch of business cards and flyers from other local businesses in the area. So, what I realize is a lot of barbershops are doing this for free, and you're giving away free promo. What I recommend is that you charge for that real estate. Now, think about it. If you, for example, a dentist, if they need leads, they need people inquiring about them, just say, hey, for $20 a month or 15, whatever you want to charge, just say, hey, I'll put your business card right in front of my customers so they'll all see your business. It's a great value, and you can charge more for it depending on how many people you got coming to your shop. If you're a shop and you have, let's say, 1,000 people coming to your place a month, you can sell that. You can say, hey, I have 1,000 people coming in every month. I have 1,500 people coming in every month. Or if you're a smaller shop, you can even leverage those numbers. The thing is that people are going to be seeing it, and you can guarantee that they'll be seeing it because you'll literally be cutting them right then and there. So it's a great way to make some extra cash is by selling real estate and taking advantage of what you have that's in front of you right now. And number seven, referrals. Now, this kind of follows with what I just said when it comes to talking about creating strategic relationships with other business owners. What I mean by referrals is referring your clientele that you're cutting to their business. So let's say, for example, if one of my friends or someone I created a partnership with is a car salesperson, and I say, hey, I see X amount of clients a day. If I send you any business, will you give me a flat fee? And most likely they'll say yes because they're getting business from you. So you can negotiate that fee. You can say, hey, I want $50 for everyone, I want $100 for everyone that I send to you that buys a car. And they say, deal. You know, most salespeople will do it because the thing is it's a referral. And for them, in their eyes, it's a much easier sale when they're getting referred by someone versus somebody who just came in off the lot, right? So if I'm a salesperson or a car salesperson and I see that you're gonna send me business, I'm gonna pay you for that. And that doesn't just go for salespeople or car salespeople, it can go for any business. If you say, hey, if you know someone who owns a restaurant, or you know someone who owns a car detailing spot, or a med spa, or a doctor's office, or dentist, say, hey, I see X amount of people and different people every day. I can send you business. If I send you business, will you give me a fee? Yes, I will. And let's work out a deal. Great way to bring in some extra cash, and you're still leveraging your brand that you already built, right? So again, you don't want to be referring people just that. You don't want to be referring your clients to anyone who's willing to give you a dollar. Obviously, do some research, do your due diligence, make sure that whoever you're referring your clients to are actually good people, and that way you don't end up jeopardizing that relationship that you took so long to build. And number eight, selling your knowledge. Now, I'm pretty sure you guys seen enough webinars, enough YouTube videos, enough things on Instagram to kind of get an idea of what I'm talking about. What I mean is take all your knowledge and experience and package it up into an ebook or an online training series, a video course. That way you'll be able to help people get past the mistakes that you may have done in your career. So if you are a barber with 10 plus years of experience or five, whatever it is, but you're highly skilled and your designs and your work shows for it, people are going to want to learn how to do those same things. So package it all up, say, hey, this is how you do this cut, this is how you do that, this is how I was able to grow my following. Whatever you've been able to do and improve in your own business, you can sell that. That way you can, you know, help people get to where you are, help them avoid the mistakes that you may have made in your business so they don't repeat them. This is a great way to add value to the marketplace and a great side hustle to bring in some residual or passive income. And that wraps it up. So thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate you. If you guys have any specific questions you want me to cover in my next video, definitely let me know. Post about it in my group. I have a private Facebook group called Barbers Hangout. If you're not familiar, get familiar, join the group. We're offering free marketing support to all barbers and shop owners that are getting hit by COVID-19 and just need to get pointed in the right direction of how to bounce back. Definitely join that group. You'll get content like this, especially things that are exclusive to the group, like free consultations, and we can do free Instagram and social media audits to help you further push the needle in your business. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Definitely helps push the algorithm in our favor to help get this these kind of content to more other barbers who need to see it. That wraps it up for today. Thank you so much again for watching this. I appreciate you. I'll see you on the next video. Take care.